Okay. I am heading out the front door. A little bit looking around because the bear was seen today. I'm heading up to the shower house up there. I'm taking you with me because you could actually see me get eaten by a bear today, so this could end up being exciting. If I'm getting taken out, I want to be in pictures. Be in a blaze of glory. So here we go on our little walk to the greenhouse shower, outdoor solar shower. Beautiful day. Here's our house once again. Little lily pond I dug. Lilies are coming up. Our nice recycled house, made of recycled buildings, built with my own hands. Recycled, not buildings, but materials. The roof, of course, was new, but part of the roofing was initially given to us, and then we ended up buying the rest of it at a reduced price. For some reason, it was, I think, leftovers from some previous work that I had done. These are solariums. See, underground, partially underground, seven-sided dome with a back house that was originally the house we lived in before we built the dome onto it. Here's one of our 200 plus fruit trees that I planted from little tiny babies that were found way out in the woods and such. And these are apple trees, and we went out and found them. They had an interesting story. The Chinese workers of the railroad that built the one railroad across Canada, as they moved along the railroad sites, they had little camp areas, and they planted fruit trees for something to eat along the way, and they would go back to them and gather the fruit and such. I guess they lived at the camps. Now the camps are deep in the woods and forgotten and totally grown over, but we went and found them out and got baby trees from them, mini orchards from different locations, but none of them are bought. All these fruit trees, like 200 plus, with our baby trees in them. The baby tree nursery are all free fruit trees. If you look around, know what to look for. They're out there. Indoor figs, apples, 50 indoor fig trees grown from one leaf, apples, plums, lots of plums, and cherry trees. Here is our little greenhouse. It's just a joy. We had another one that was more dome shaped, and it got crushed by this tree with the camera a security camera system on it. Let me see there. This giant tree. There's no way of seeing how huge it is. I'll line it up with the greenhouse. Give you an idea how big it is. It's one of our giant trees in our yard. But this is the water line. Runs to plumbing that comes to the creek you might hear. You're also probably hearing the creek is basically a long waterfall. Comes from up there from the mountain. We live highest up, so we had the first water. It comes off the water comes from a lake that's right on top of it. The the lake was an old volcano that water rose up into it, and there is a monster, a dragon, that lives up to the lake. That's not just me, that's what the natives, they call them Natash or something, I think. I can't quite remember. I'm getting old. But, yeah, he's pretty scary. Pretty scary flying dragon that goes underwater. He's been seen in many lakes around here by locals also. I think my personal take is that the lakes are connected to the one on top of the mountain. And he just goes from lake to lake. And how that works, I'm not really sure, but I think he also flies. It seems like I've heard him land on my house. Something landed on the house a number of times. Something very large and winged has landed on the house. But this stuff always happens when I'm home alone, so, which is most of the time, so I'm the only documenter, and of course, I'm crazy, so what do I know? But other people in the neighborhood have actually seen it. Of course, they're crazy also, so what do we all know? This is the greenhouse I designed and built. It is made basically, it's very simple, from 25 pieces of cut upright wood lined up. It's what they call a star. I knew the guy who originally, you might remember those star spinning star sticks, I think they call them, spinning sticks. People take the dead shows and festivals and stuff. The same guy designed these domes. Him and his son traveled the world designing these domes, and I met him years ago and in a hippie community, no doubt. And all of us, by the time he left, we all had domes. We all built our own domes. I built a 3-story version of this that they say 20-something years later is still quite an impressive structure down in Florida. Of course, it's not plastic. This one's all plastic, so it's a greenhouse. But we put a little cement floor with drain in it. Hammock. You can kind of see the ceiling design. We made it so ours. I'm documenting this also because I want to build one with my son on our other farm for a greenhouse. This is the opening top. The top was actually all that's left from our previous
All right.
Sorry. I guess this has a 10-minute timer. It shows how long I can talk. These are heated water, hot water, passive hot water method that works really nice. I'll go outside and show you to you again. On a sunny day, this is the one that was recently designed. It's basically a stick with a bunch of holders on it with a coiled plastic holding them nailed into position so that when they get heavy with water, they don't, and then it was set after the fact on top of the dome in order to create pressure. But it's really quite a lovely method. It works very nice. Let me see if I can go up here without getting eaten by the bear. The other one was just kind of coiled loops, and it gets kind of heavy and dribbly, and it's kind of grown, the trees have grown tall around it now, so it didn't get as much sun. There's also one you could barely see underneath the plastic, because we've recovered it a few times from UV. Just put a new layer on there for so many years. But you could finish these domes out with wood, and they're very nice little guest houses and such. But 25 uprights of, what is that, about 8 to 10 feet each, made into triangular shapes, all cut so that they form a triangle, inverted and outverted, that's what, and then coming together at the top. Ours is particularly arched on top in order to be more snow-bearing and to accommodate for the opening on top to let the heat out. Because even though it's quite cold most of the time up here in Canada, it can get hot in the greenhouse. This greenhouse, which is extremely tall, it's basically two stories. I used to grow tomatoes in all the way to the roof. Basil, cucumbers, tomatoes. This is the water before was holding up the plants. And no, I never grew marijuana in here. I quit marijuana long before any of this was built. And then, when we relocated our old bathhouse, we put this bath from the bathhouse up here. A little shower hanger around it, and then the water comes in here and drops in, and we have a little shower spigot here. It's really a nice little setup. I'm showing you all the details. I remember, and if you're interested in building one, we've got these little kind of supports in each corner that kind of strengthen the building. And these are our pots and stuff. You gotta have a hammock in your own house. Just way too luxurious. But, yeah, we've got the stick system. I'm holding the thing up right now. And the door to keep the bear out. Ha ha. Right. I've got my crocheting going on. Come out here and think. I took my naps. I'm going to sit here and talk for the rest of my 4 minutes, I guess. But before I take a shower. So far, I'm alive, no bear. So, I might get y'all excited about nothing. Oh, this is interesting. Then we put in here. That is a wood stove. Alright. Barrel wood stove. Sitting in another barrel that holds a gas water heater on top. And the purpose of a gas water heater is they have a continuous hole that goes to the very top. If you can see that, it's the top of me. And so the output for the smoke from the gas from the wood stove goes up through the water heater, and the wood stove is sitting on the water heater, goes up to the water heater, and the smoke goes out the roof. And it stays amazingly warm, you know, with very little wood. It heats up this greenhouse really well, very little wood. And so it's good for early spring starts and late fall keeping of things, if you want to keep a little bit longer. And very little wood will heat that water up. But in the summer, it's unnecessary because you got your passive hot water solar heating up, which I'll enjoy a long shower, probably longer than I could stand of hot water. But that tank there will heat up really quick on very little wood. Well, it's been an interesting week. Beltane Festival. I guess if you're hearing this, you survived the unholy week and May 1st. Everybody I've talked to is kind of seeming like they're getting their spiritual footing back that they kind of lost with the witch's holiday. Some rough times, but amazing times. I do think that in equal balance to the darkness that's being flooded into these stargates and veil gates and such, being put up all over the world, like London, the recreation of the Tower of Babel. Hundreds of them continually from here to eternity, ushering in the fallen ones along with CERN and all the other stargates they built. But I believe that even as these spirits and fallen angels flood in, that Yahweh's people shall be connected more and more as a body of Christ. And we will be strengthened as a body in equal share as long as we stay in His Word and follow it and every day, not slip, not fall back, not lag back, you know, always stay in constant prayer. Had some people come out here the other day, kind of intervention, and because we hadn't been in a church building for a while, and I'm like, I'm always like, people say, when was the last time you were in church? And I'm like, did I ever leave church? When's the last time I left church? Our bodies are the temple of God, of Yahweh. Well, I've got 30 seconds, so. Blessings, everyone. I'm going to take my shower now. Thanks for bearing with me. And hopefully I'll survive my walk back. If not, over and out. It's been a great life. Love to everybody. Blessings in Yahweh and Yeshua's name. Peace to everyone.